A very good morning to all of you. Myself, Anubhuti Saxena, I am your science teacher. Today, I am going to teach you science lesson 4, part 4. Let's start. Today, we will discuss the question answers of this lesson. First question is, how are herbivorous different from carnivorous? How are herbivorous different from carnivorous? Herbivorous, first point. Herbivorous are animals that eat only plant and plant parts. Herbivorous are animals that eat only plant and plant parts. Carnivorous, first. Carnivorous are animals that eat the flesh of their animals. Carnivorous are animals that eat the flesh of other animals. Herbivorous, second point. They have sharp incisors to bite into plants and strong molars to chew them. They have sharp incisors to bite into plants and strong molars to chew them. Carnivorous, they have sharp canines to tear the flesh. They have sharp canines to tear the flesh. Third point, herbivorous, for example, cow, goat, horse and zebra. Cow, goat, horse and zebra. Carnivorous, for example, tigers and lions. Tigers and lions. Question number 2. How is a camel adapted to survive in the hot deserts? How is a camel adapted to survive in the hot deserts? And the answer is, camel is adapted to survive in the hot deserts in the following ways. First, it can drink almost 15 buckets of water in one gulp and can store water in its stomach. It can drink almost 15 buckets of water in one gulp and can store water in its stomach. Second, it can store food in its hump. In the form of fat, it can store food in its hump in the form of fat. Third point, it has long eyelashes which help to keep out the desert sand. It has long eyelashes which help to keep out the desert sand. Number 4, it has broad feet that enables it to walk on the sand without sinking into it. Next question, how are polar bears adapted to survive in the snow? Polar bears are adapted to survive in the snow in the following ways. First, point, they have fur on their bodies to keep themselves warm. Second, they have fat under their skin that they use as food in winters. Next question, number 4. How is a frog adapted to live on land as well as in water? Answer is, a frog is adapted to live on land as well as in water because first, it has limbs that help him to move on land and swim in water. It has limbs that help it to move on land and swim in water. Second, it breathes with the help of its lungs on land and moist skin in water. Third, a frog uses its webbed feet to swim in water and hop on the land. Question number 5. How is a fish adapted to live in water? And our answer is, a fish is adapted to live in water in the following ways. First, it has gills to breathe in oxygen dissolved in water. Second, it has boat-shaped bodies. That enable it to swim in water. Third point, the fish has fins to swim. Now question number 6 is, what features in a bird enables it to fly? Answer is, birds have light, hollow bones, wings with feathers, and a streamlined body that enables them to fly. Next is question number 7. What are parasites? Answer is, animals that live in or on the body of other animals are called parasites. For example, leeches, fleas and bed bugs, etc. Next question is, how are aquatic animals different from terrestrial animals? And our answer is, terrestrial animals. Animals that live on land are. Called terrestrial animals. For example, tiger, cow, goat, horse, and even human beings live on land, etc. Aquatic animals. Animals that live in the water are called aquatic animals. Animals that live in the water are called aquatic animals. For example, octopus, turtle, etc. Octopus, turtle, etc. Next question, define the terms. First is hibernation. Animals like bears, frogs, and mice find it difficult to survive in the extreme cold and because of the lack of food. During winters, they take a long sleep in holes, caves, or underground. This long winter sleep is called hibernation. Animals like bears, frogs, and mice find it difficult to survive in the extreme cold and because of the lack of food. During winters, they take a long sleep in holes, in caves, or underground. This long winter sleep is called hibernation. This long winter sleep is called hibernation. Second, camouflage. Next is camouflage. The special features of some animal is to merge with their surroundings in order to protect themselves from their enemies. Means the special features of some animals to merge with their surroundings in order to protect themselves from their enemies. This is camouflage. Next is adaptation. An animal develops a particular type of body behavior and habits to adjust in its surroundings. This is called adaptation. An animal develops a particular types of body behavior and An animal develops a particular type of body behavior and habits to adjust in its surroundings. This is called adaptation. Now, hearts are there. Hearts question 1. Is a predator bigger or smaller than its prey? Explain. Is a predator bigger or smaller than its prey? Explain. And the answer is, a predator is bigger than its prey as the bigger size of the predator helps the predator to hunt its prey easily. A predator is bigger than its prey as the bigger size of the predator helps the predator to hunt its prey easily. Question number 2. Most small desert animal stay in their burrows during the daytime. They came out of them only during the night. Explain why. So our answer will be, almost all desert animals are small enough to stay out of the sun during the hottest part of the day. Almost all desert animals are small enough to stay out of the sun during the hottest part of the day. They stay They stay there underground in burrows. They stay there. They stay deep underground in burrows. At night, after the sun goes down and the sun cools off, the animals come out to hunt for food. At night, after the sun goes down and the sand cools off, the animals come out to hunt for food. Now, our chapter is completed. All the exercises and questions answers are done. So everybody will note down on the copy and learn it, all the exercise properly. Thank you everyone and have a nice day.